I'm Sir Tap Tap, and welcome to Let's Play Life of Pixel. Pixel was a little green pixel. Parker, get down. A review copy of this game was provided free of charge from the developer. Oh, I guess I gotta... Okay. Pixel wanted to see more. He found a world of retro joy. So I'm gonna go ahead and admit, I kinda passed over on this game initially because I saw, oh, like, Pixel, I don't really like its look, but then I took a look closer and, for one thing, some really good chiptune, and it does a pretty good job of simulating the quirks and stuff of all these different retro systems. So I know people are kinda tired of the whole... Well, some people anyway are tired of the whole retro stuff, but this game really does all these retro systems pretty well. Like, it emulates quirks reasonably well. I love the animation for that guy down there. And the Game Boy stage, honestly, when I saw the Game Boy stage, that's when I decided I would check this out. Because it looks really good, and just so happens the music's pretty awesome too. So I've already played a little, as you can see from the completion. And so, for each system, there's a set of 8 levels, I think. I'm not really sure what you're supposed to do to get through those guys. I'm just gonna take a hit. And it's got a nice timer there if you want to be a speedrunner. There is a double jump, which lets you skip some of this stuff. A lot of the enemies and stages are sort of, oops, varying degrees of subtlety, but, oh crap. Lots of references to retro games, of course. Like, those bats look very Mega Man to me. We're just gonna, ugh. I don't like that this expects me to wait. I'm not a patient man. Not a man at all, I'm a spike ball, but still, I'm not a patient whatever I am. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to take damage to rush through those. But yeah, the sound effects, visuals, and the way the screen even scrolls is different in each world because of, you know, the hardware limitations of the system you're visiting or whatever you want to call it. Then spikes are always instant kill. I'm not sure if you noticed that. In fact, I'm probably going to get very frustrated because of the spikes at some of these levels. I really hate how the spikes slowly retract. We got a... I guess that was a Tetramino? But it was special. Yeah, the spikes slowly retract, and until like halfway down, they're still instant kill. And I find them highly frustrating. Alright, this is safe. So there's some awkward moments like that jump there where you have to be really quite quick. And water is also death. Should have remembered that. Oh, and there's also gems. I've already collected the ones in this level, in the last few levels here. Like, not these gems. There's different gems, okay? There's... yeah. Oh. That's new. I didn't even notice he had a little walking sound. Oh goodness. What? Shut up, phone. Nobody likes you. Oh god. Oh, okay. Is my host... am I supposed to be up here, or...? Oh god, are you kidding? Why? Go in the door, Pixel. Was there supposed to be a thing? I get a feeling there was supposed to be a thing to put me back down. Break my balls here, Pixel. I was only gonna show a few levels of each world anyway. Cause I like to show the variety. So yeah, let's look at... Specky. I'm gonna admit, I don't have any nostalgia for 80s computer systems. Oh, yeah, and it has a cute little blurb about each spec, each console slash PC. And I know enough about this Spectrum to know the color palette is one of the defining features of it. And you can talk to this guy, I don't think he ever has anything interesting to say. And yeah, it has this interesting color clash effect, like you can see that guy coloring the spikes and stuff. And it's pretty cool that they emulate those. Like, I'm sure these aren't entirely faithful, but they emulate enough of the quirks to sort of rub that feeling in there. And that's something I kinda... not entirely miss, but... well, that was pointless. Like, it was kind of neat that when, you know, you saw an N64 game and a PS1 game, you could tell which one was which, because, you know, the PS1 had those wobbly polygons, and it was very sharp. And... N64 was more stable, and, you know, like, because it had a Z-buffer. That's why... the PS1 doesn't have a Z-buffer, so that's why it wobbles. What the... that's new. Parker. Get down. See, that's why pit polygons wobble on the PS1, and they don't on the N64. I don't even know what happened here. But yeah, like, this thing doesn't scroll. I guess Spectrum games must just be instant transitions, not screen scrolls. I have no idea what's going on. Yeah, it introduces new gimmicks and stuff each world. So I guess we're a bubble car now. That's cool. And once again, those... what? Alright. Just gotta... alright, screw the car. I just want out of here. No! I just... bubble, please. Bubble. Oop. Bubble Y. Whatever. I don't appreciate that secret. The way he jumps is interesting. Like, oh, I do have to go down there. Wait, no. That's kind of mean. The score timer is, like, hiding that hole up here. Whatever. I'm not sure why that stuck pixel is there. Your screen does not have a stuck pixel, the game just does that. And the game gets fairly difficult in the later areas. Yeah, I really hate those spikes, because you're never really quite sure when they're gonna... I guess there's probably a tell that, like, speedrunners could know. But there's never an exact tell that they're harmless now. Lovely color palettes on the Spectrum. I only mean that half sarcastically. Like, they certainly have a lot of personality. Let's take a look at a different world. There's so many different worlds to look at. I'm not even particularly familiar with this one. The Amstrad... oh, it's a 64? Sort of thing. Oh god, this is one of the cassette loaders. Please don't emulate cassette loading. No one deserves that. Okay, good. Yeah, it's really cool to see the different, like, eras, and they do it pretty well. Alright, come out, spikes. The spikes, just really not a fan of that. What's up, Mr. Professor Ow? If you notice, the enemies have different, like, eras. The enemies are lots of the same. But they have different sprites for each different era. What's up? I'm sure the game has nasty secrets because it's... Hello. There are the gems, and there's also these special... Like, when I bit... Oh, dang it, that wasn't... There was an ice cream cone. Damn it, Pixel! Lots of secrets, and I'm not yet sure what that's exactly about. Someone in the comments probably does. Yeah, there are these secrets, and let's go ahead and find that again. Special! Those disappear once picked up, and I'm not particularly sure what they're for yet. And there's obviously those gems, too. Pyramid of Doom! Oh god. And that's why it's called the Pyramid of Doom. What's that blue switch? I gotta press it. Eh? What? I don't know what that did. Oh. That's what that did. Okay. Oh god! No! These spikes will be the death of me. Literally. Damn it! No! Oh man, that's gonna be annoying. The game seems like it's going to be very hard, which is why I only want to show a few levels of each thing. But I guess this one's more just about planning. You gotta think before you go on. But they definitely get harder as you go on here. I was not familiar with this PC system, as I said. I find its look is pretty interesting. Excuse me. Nope! Oh, god. Ceiling spikes, my old nemesis. I kind of wish the spikes were not animated and they just popped in and out. That would make this a lot easier, actually. The point at which they're no longer lethal is when they're like half in. Yeah, go into the spikes. No, that's not into the spikes. Oh god, oh god. Okay, okay, okay. Salvaged it. I'm just expecting spikes on the ceiling at this point. That's just what this game would do. Spikes? No. I wish I could look down. Oh god. One interesting quirk of this game, I guess it's only- Oh my god. We finished that level, okay? I guess it's only direct input support because I had to remap the controls for myself. But the controller support's quite nice. What should we... Let's take a look at the Amiga. I'm not especially familiar with the Amiga either. I know it had the... Didn't it have Metal Gear? So it's about SNES quality. What did you say? Eh, whatever. How dare you throw barrels at me? What do you think you are, some sort of ape? I really like how Pixel controls, like, there's an ideal part of the jump to double jump in if you want to do the most height versus the most, oh god, horizontal distance. Excuse me, I need to get behind you. How dare you fire at diagonals? Oh god. I did not think my cunning plan the whole way through. Whatever. Aw. Should've just rushed him. Ah! Damn it. Did I already... Yeah, I did. Well, I learned something today. I didn't realize there was quite, like, non-DOS computers of, like, SNES. Oh my god. The spikes of, like, SNES quality, like, graphics. The only retro PCs I've had, if they even qualify, are an old... I'm not sure if it was actually DOS or if it was, like, 3.1, but I only played DOS games on it. And, a very low amount of colors Mac. That was our first, I think, only Apple PC at home ever. These levels are much bigger than the other ones. Well, not much, but I mean... Darn you, momentum. We meet again. Shut up, phone. Phone really wants to join in today. But nobody likes Phone, unlike Parker, so he doesn't get to talk. Are you kidding? Okay, I gotta go on this, right? Oh, cripes. Okay, easier... Yeah, whatever. Pretend I didn't do any of that. Frickin' physics here. You call those physics? I wouldn't brush my teeth with those physics. Oh good, we've got lasers, that's great. I'm excited for this. Oh my god. We're done with this level. It's almost too tempting to rage quit on these because you can just try a different one. Alright, let's take one... What is this, a Game & Watch? Not quite, but... Huh. Where did all the color go? Wait, there's a gem! I think that was a gem. Interesting. See, this game is an educational experience. I have no idea what, like, about this console. I should have listened to the blurb. We're gonna watch the blurb. I guess this is a good starter level. I mean, I'm sure there is a difficulty progression between worlds in addition to the ones within them. So, like, SNES is probably harder than... Like, this is obviously one of the easier ones. At least it is so far. And I somehow- oh my god. I somehow doubt this computer could even animate those spikes that way. Dang it. When you get the gem, you keep it forever, so you don't actually have to survive getting the gem. It's obviously, like, some sort of deep commentary on greed with the gems. Alright. Let's not die. I just want to see one more level of this world. Not bad music here, either. Oh yeah, this is obviously easy mode world. Let's not die now that I've said that, because that would be embarrassing. Should I finish this world? Maybe I should. Finish at least one world. Oh crap. Not even sure what those tentacle things are like. I guess they're tentacle things. I guess that answers my own question, never mind. I should have got that first before fussing with all this other crap, shouldn't I? Oh well. The flowing stuff is surely water, so it's gonna kill us. What?! I was on... Whatever, game. Alright, anything interesting? Oh, right, I wanted to hear what this... what the crap this thing is. Sinclair! A mail order kit. Oh wow, block character graphics from built-in character set. Interesting. Alright. I guess there's some hidden worlds. Let's take a look at the BBC Micro. Oh god, nice sound. Old computers made great sounds. Oh, right. Death water. Pixels aren't soluble. Or maybe they are soluble. Not sure what solubility has to do with you dying in water, honestly. Just felt like something I should say. Perhaps I shouldn't have. Too late now. Go away, Mega Man Bat. You were never on the system. At least I don't think you were. Oh, these are what those were. I mean, they're kind of, but they're kind of not tentacles. Like, they're tentacle monsters. Oh. Yeah, that's one problem the game has, is it likes to let you drop onto, like, unseeingness. Like, not see where you're dropping. I have word issues with talk face thing. This game's destroying my ability to talk, I'm sorry. What's up, buddy? What do you gotta say? Oh, crap. There's secrets? I think it's this one he's talking about. Yep. I guess that guy's a hint to... Oh, wait. That's what I thought. Alright. Now what? Please don't tell me you trapped me here for no reason. You did, didn't you? I don't get it. Oh well. Let's take a look at SNES World. We're about done here. Some obviously Zelda-inspired background. And that Yoshi's Island coin sound, I'll never forget that. Okay. Okay. Spikes! I really don't appreciate them spikes. Ah, whatever. I didn't need that health. Oh god. Maybe I did need that health. Okay. Yeah, do your BS. Alright. I don't even want to waste my life to get that special thing. Alright. Let's get out of here. Sunset Castle. Snakes! It always has to be snakes. Hello, Mr. What? Oh, good. There's freaking... There's spikes coming from the walls now, too. That is exactly what I needed right now. I guess they're spears, but whatever. Same thing. A spear is just a spike on a stick. I'm not sure why Pixel loses, like, his bodily essence when he walks and lands. Like, that can't be good. Like, he's made of greenness, and he loses some of that greenness as he walks? That's... or lands, at least. I do not feel safe. Some Castlevania backgrounds going on here. Hey, I'm on that flag! Why am I on that flag? Oh good, there's spikes from the bottom now, too. Good. I'm glad. Excellent. Okay. Fire! See, the levels are definitely longer as you go on the more advanced systems. Ow. What are you? You're just a pushable thing? Oh goodness. Okay. Don't want what you're selling, buddies. Stupid foreground. Gonna kick you right in the parallax. Not that there is foreground parallax going on. Do these block spikes? No, they don't. They're stuck pixels again. I don't know why this game does that. Nervous. I was almost right. Alright. Alright. There we go. Are you kidding me? What did I miss? Oh, for Pete's sakes. And I'm dead. I don't like SNES World. Did I miss this? I'm gonna be so ticked if that's what I missed. Okay, I have to see the end of this level now. I went too far not to. Ah. Maybe I should have played in order. The difficulty is clearly intends you to do that. I just didn't want to do that because I wanted to show off all the different worlds. Smooth moves. Alright. Oh god. Friggin' spikes. Those spikes make me seriously paranoid. Like, Mega Man never had it so bad. At least his spikes were stationary. Mostly. I do like that every world has new assets and stuff. Not even every world, every level. Oh god, I am amazed I'm not dead. So yeah, while it is doing the whole remember the 90s and 80s thing, it definitely has a lot of know, its own stuff. Oh, what is going on behind that pillar? Seriously. Ah, whatever. There's like a... Whatever. Never mind. I don't even... Right, these. Okay, that's the sound of the door opening. I have no idea when the spears end. I'm just gonna be super cautious. I'm pretty sure the designs are supposed to skip two every time. Alright. Megapixel! Oh. I wonder what this could possibly be referencing. Wait, what? That's just rude. I... There must be something I'm missing here. That guy's a jerk. I don't like that guy. Also, I'm pretty sure he's the exact same sprite from the Armstad or whatever the heck that was. Spikes, man. The frickin' spikes. I guess all the other worlds are probably supposed to be exact references to one other game, but I just don't recognize any of them except for the SNES ones. Because I'm a 90s kid. Oh my god. The spikes. Why would you do this to me? Do you enjoy my pain, Mr. Game Creator? Do you enjoy it? Wait, did I just jump twice? Wait. What happened here? Do I, like, refresh my jump after getting these, or... I don't get how I was supposed to get that one. Not a fake wall. I don't understand this. I don't like this level. Well, I think that's a pretty thorough look at- Oh, we're almost done with this one. Alright, we'll actually finish one world. The Sinclair whatever its face is. There's some seriously wonky collision going on there with those things. And those things. Okay, just don't even get near the water tiles, like... Their death extends above themselves, somehow. Alright. The robot is watching. He's a creeper. Ouch. The interesting thing about the way Pixel jumps is... He's got a fixed height jump. But due to the way the double jump affects it, like, when you do the double jump, you know, will change your actual total jump height. So it's interesting. Though there's also periods where just the minimum jump height will send you straight into spikes, which is of course frustrating. This is just nasty. Yep. That's pretty nasty. This is still one of the easier levels, though. I was obviously supposed to do one world at a time. That water! The water is just nasty, I'll give you that. Okay. Oh goodness, that's rude. Excuse me? I like how his mouth is animated by the little... what do you call that? Oh my god! No. The spikes, man! Why would you do this to another human being? Are you even a human being? Did a human being make this? Or is this an evil plot by the robots? I don't even know why the spikes give me such trouble. Like, it's not super hard, it's just the spikes are like, hey, I'm gonna ruin your whole day. And by whole day, I mean the past 20 seconds of your life. Sometimes days last 20 seconds. So what happens when we- oh, it just goes to the next one. Okay. I think we've now seen all of them. Well, let's take a look at SNES after we've- or not SNES, NES. Since we've already taken a peek at everything else. There's that generic bubbly sound that every single Codemasters game uses. I mean, probably not the modern ones, but I wouldn't be surprised based on their 8-bit output. There's some I forget if it's Treasure Island Dizzy, but they have this one game where the entire game is just like three of these bubbly sound effects layered on top of each other, and it's like ear bleeding. Ouch. I'm not sure could this thing even do gradients like this? I don't think so. I don't know. I do not have nostalgia for this system. I'd never owned it. I'm not really a fan of pre-NES games in general. Let's take a look at the last section. Obvious Mega Man stage. Everyone knows the NES. So yeah, lots of interesting hidden stuff. Seems like it'd be a fun game to speedrun. Wait a minute, what did he say? I managed to read that entire thing and just like... Alright, so the star blocks give you crap. We saw that in the SNES world though. Hello, Gem. Come here. Yoink. Out of the way. I missed gems, didn't I? Or whatever these are. There's two different types of gems. Why would you do this to my brain? I can't words that many times. Oh, I did get all of them. Okay. Security guards. Why would you use security guards when you're obviously just going to fill everything with spikes instead? You can move the camera? My entire life is a lie. I quit.
Oh god.
That's why you land on stuff, because you're supposed to use the camera. I'm stupid, I'm sorry. Oh god. Pixel, no. Pixel, no! Okay. Hey. Jerk. And there's spikes. Of course there's spikes. In fact, there's been surprisingly few spikes considering this is a Mega Man world. Old. Okay, I think since I've proved that I'm incredibly stupid and didn't think to try and look up and down, I think we're about done with Life of Pixel here. This is a pretty cool look through all these different retro worlds. I appreciate that it goes through like multiple eras, well, mostly just two eras, but lots of different systems. Whereas most... Why did I do that? I know there's a laser there. Lasers are instant kill. Good. I don't even want that gem now. Oh, who am I saying? It's a gem. Of course I want it. It's shiny, and it's a collectible. And it disappears forever after you've picked it up. I just have to get it. I can't help myself. Physically incapable of helping myself. Oh god, oh god, okay. Enemy patterns don't seem 100% predictable. Well, depending. I'm not sure it's possible to get that without dying. That or it has to be, like, frame perfect or some crap. But whatever. It doesn't matter. Gems disappear forever. Didn't mean to show off quite this much of this, honestly. I guess that means it's addictive. That or I'm just stupid and I don't know when to stop. But hey, we're almost done. We're almost done from the abuse of the spikes that still kill you while they're retracting. Go away. Mr. Frickin' Diagonal Fire. So rude when enemies get diagonal fire in these games and you don't. Well, I can't even shoot at all, but still. Pachinko Pixel. I don't get the reference here. Honestly, these just all look like Mega Man levels to me. Well, not the background. Oh, good. Well, I think that's enough of a look into the life of Pixel. There's leaderboards! Let's take a look at our... I guess you can speedrun the game in slightly over an hour. More like 2 hours, if you're reasonably decent, maybe. I'm not going to speedrun this game. There's also options. You can fully remap the controls, which is unfortunately rare in PC games. Like, let people do that, please. Oh, and you can do color effects and TV distortion if you want. Not really a fan of those. I'm fine with the default palette for each of these things. Well, I wasn't playing Pixel Perfect. Let's see how that affects things. I don't know, it looks about the same. But yeah, that is Life of Pixel. As always, there will be a link in the description where you can go find it on Steam.